Hey everyone, it's Brandy. You are watching AbstractCrafter, and we are doing a draw with me today. I promised you a nice long one, so see what I can do for you. We're going to work on this tag here. I got this from Fruitini. She did it on her channel just a few days ago, so I will link that up in the eye. Go check it out if you haven't subscribed to Fruitini. Yet, I don't know what you're doing. You should. She does a lot of drill with me. She does unboxings and, you know, all the stuff that we like, that we've come to like as diamond painters. So, well, let me kind of move and get situated. And for the first time in a very long time, we do have our co-pilot Talyn joining us and his BFF, Princess the Pig. She'll be making random appearances here and again. He's actually gonna show her in right now. It doesn't have as much space as she once did because my setup is different. I used to have a lot more room for her to sneak a peek underneath. So, we will be working on this huacan. I don't have anything as far as updates, really. I haven't done a whole lot. I've been sick, so there hasn't been a whole lot going on. I've been trying to stay as updated as possible in my new Facebook group, AbstractCrafter-Creativity Unlocked. If you haven't joined that, please do. I'd love to have you. If groups aren't your thing, I also have a page, AbstractCrafterYT. I also have Instagram now. I'm just kind of did it all at once. I don't know what I was thinking. So, and that is at @abstract_crafter. I will most likely be more active on Instagram because I like it better. So, if you don't remember, I'll see if I can move this into view. We're working on the huacan butterfly. And I will link this down below for anybody that wants it. This is the smallest one that I've ordered off of AliExpress. It's a 40 by 30, 35 color. And this white color here has been replaced. It was... oh, and you might hear my heater kicking in and out. I don't know if the mic picks that up very well or not. But this white color, it was 3756, which is a really pretty white with a bit of a milky greenish tint. It's really pretty, but when I went to go order replacements, they didn't have any. So also tonight, we'll be trying out this drill pen that I made. I got this at the dollar store for a dollar, and I converted it into a drill pen. It does have a cap. I just don't know where it is. Oh, and look at, there's chocolate on my diamond painting. Be gone with you, was my quick snack. I needed some sugar. So yeah, I converted this. It wasn't easy because it didn't quite fit inside there. So I glued it in. I made it work. And I am enjoying my new setup so much. I have so much more room. I can see things. I can set things up better. So why don't we get working? And I do have some. These actually have spilled on the floor last night. I was working on my lap. I don't have like a lap table or anything. And I was working on my lap and I pushed a little too hard and it flipped over. Oh, here's the cap. So it does have a little cap that goes on it. And I'm going to like that because that will make my putty last so much longer. And this is actually a mix of Aileen's, Elmer's, Pick Me Up Pen, and what else? The blue tack from Loctite. There we go. It's a mixture of all of those. It just so happens that the Aliens is on top. I really like having a mixture of all of them. It does a really good job. So this painting, if you can't tell, is one of the most confetti-laden paintings I have ever done. And then, in fact, I am a little bit of a perfectionist, so I'm going back and forth between the Evermoment tweezers and the drill pen. Because as you know, we had to retire Fred. And even though he is retired, this is his piece in the end here. So, he still is with us in just in a new way. So, I don't have much for updates. I do have a couple things. Like I had said in yesterday's video, and if you didn't watch that, that was an unboxing of diamond paintings that I freaking got from Walmart, of all places. I knew it wouldn't be long before Walmart got their hands in the pot. Can't do much of anything without Walmart needing to get involved in it, in every aspect of life. Let's see here. We may need to pause and do something with lighting, because it may look okay now, but it gets pretty dark. So yeah, in yesterday's unboxing, I did say that I would let you guys know what was going on as far as me being kind of sick, because I haven't really been super active in my Facebook group or Instagram or Diamond Painting Underground or in the DPAL. I don't really know. It's not like a flu or a cold per se. It's more like just this weirdness going on with me. I don't sleep. I sleep like every other day. And that just, it's starting, I think, to take its toll on me. And like, typically I might think that that was due to stress, but I don't like feel stressed, I guess. Like, it's not an obvious feeling of being stressed out. So I don't really know what's going on with that. I'm gonna make a doctor's appointment. I'm due for a physical anyway, so I may as well see what's going on. Because, I mean, there's just so many other little things. And, of course, when you don't sleep, so many things can go horribly wrong with your body. You absolutely 100% need sleep, and you should have at least 7 to 8 hours. And so even on the days that I am sleeping, I'm getting, like, 2, 3, if I'm lucky. Sometimes, if I do happen to sleep every night, it is the typical, anywhere between 2 and 4 hours. And then on the nights that I'm not sleeping and I'm taking a nap, I am taking a nap for like an hour and I'm good to go. It's not healthy. And if you haven't been with me from very early on, Princess is known to be in my drill with me, as I probably have gained about 1,000 subs since the last time that she was in a video. So there's quite a few of you that may not know her. And Talyn is my youngest son. And he has an absolute love and adoration for pigs. I mean, it's beyond an obsession at this point. And we accept it and we support it. I was going to say encourage it, but it's not really something that you would encourage. It's just a life choice. And we're more than okay with his life choice. He doesn't eat pork or anything like that, so he's very dedicated. One thing I want to point out is up in this corner, it is completely blurry, whereas over here, it's crystal clear. So the lines over here get really fuzzy, and they can be kind of hard to tell. Specifically, let's see. Like the symbol that's on 9 here. There we go. We have that one, and then 33. Yes, it's in a different container. It has the double line on it. Let's see, I don't want it to... And so... Where'd it go? Oh, I'm covering it. So, and they're the same color, which is so annoying. And it's the most annoying thing about this whole thing, besides the fact that it's completely... The entire thing is confetti, aside from the border. Up in here, oops, it's really hard to tell which one is which. So I just kind of guessed, and used my best judgment. Even with a light pad, it's really hard to see. My voice keeps going in and out, so let me take a drink here. I don't even have anything for obsessions other than my pomegranate cherry crystal light, but I think that was an obsession in an earlier video, so I can't use it again. I have been obsessing really over organization, more so than usual, like organizing my diamond paintings. I was in a spot where I couldn't take it anymore. I had about 7 or 8 kits that weren't even kitted up. And I am one for sure that likes to have things kitted up. So if you were in my room and you looked over this way, you would see 4 kits all kitted up, ready to go. If you were to look this way on my desk, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 kitted up over there. And I have one on my table going this way that I'm working on, getting kitted. And then there is one straight ahead for Tell Me Stories that I'm still working on. Oh, and then there's Sylvanas, which is down there. I'm telling you, there is not enough space for my diamond painting obsession. I haven't even had much of a chance to do cross-stitching, and I miss it. When things are in chaos and unorganized, I feel like I can't function. And I do see, well, I've not been in therapy for quite some time. I like finished my program, but I was in therapy for my OCD. And my OCD focuses more around organization and like, mostly organization, I guess. And sometimes that can interrupt my life, like it did with the diamond paintings. And I literally just couldn't take it no more. I needed to get them all kitted up, which, I don't know, it's good and it's bad, because then by the time I'm done with it, I almost feel empty, and because I have nothing left to do other than finish a kit and be able to organize to put them away. That's quite literally all I can do. So I'm going to be peeking in occasionally, and the light still seems pretty good. So I think now we can move on and use the drill pen. It doesn't look like that there's any more random open spots. You know, on some days my OCD is okay and it doesn't bother me to have them a little bit crooked, because they do all ultimately push each other into their rightful places. But that day is not today. Today I need to use this. I really despise having so many that are not like in a group. It just makes me crazy. So let's see. I have no idea if this is gonna work. I did try it earlier with one glue, and it was the E6000 tacky glue. I don't even have it here, and it didn't work. I think I didn't give it enough time to dry out, and I went to go fill it, and it pulled the gold piece right out. So that's not what you want. And so now this, I re-glued in. I use this stuff. It's called Beacon 3-in-1 Advanced Craft Glue. I like that stuff a lot. It works really good. Oh, it stayed in, so we'll see. And that I use for building my houses, and it works a lot better. I may need to pause and get the light pad in here. I can see on the screen just fine. I see my focus is going in and out, though, as I move my hand over. Oh, that's annoying. Let's get that to autofocus. Let's see if that'll stop it from going in and out. We can't have that. See, now these are things that I wouldn't be able to know if I wasn't using, if I was using my other setup. So I'll watch that and see if it goes in and out, because there's no way I could handle that. Oh, so, and then on top of the whole not sleeping thing, I don't really suffer from migraines per se. I get a lot of sinus headaches where I live, but I don't really get a lot of migraines, but so I don't know that that's what this is, but I've been getting headaches like crazy and weird ones too. So like if I bend over, it hurts, like almost like the blood rushing to my head, or if I for some reason hold my breath. I'm trying to watch, so you know I'm getting in the way here. So you just have to bear with me. I am not used to being this close with the camera. So, and besides, if my hand is getting in the way, I've said this many times, you'll just have to deal with it because I'm diamond painting. That's almost unavoidable to get into a position where my hand is not going to get in the way. So, see, otherwise things like that happen. So, if my hand gets in the way too much, I do apologize. But most likely, nobody's really watching as much as they are listening. Because you certainly don't come to these types of videos for lessons on technique. You come to them to feel like you have somebody to diamond paint with. At least that's what I use them for. So, I'm assuming that a lot of people are also doing that. You know, and every once in a while you might glance up and take a peek at what I'm doing, but the scenery's not gonna change, guys. I've actually kind of been experimenting a little bit with time-lapse. It's a project that I've been working on, and so I thought I could do a little time-lapse on my channel. And then just do voiceovers. I do not like time-lapse set to music or set to silence. I need talking. I can't watch those because I also watch them for, you know, while I diamond paint. And time-lapse are cool, but when they get into the length of time that a full painting can take, there's no way I can sit and just watch that. I have to hear what other people are talking about. And then there's two kinds of time lapse. There's the kind where it's sped up and it's a constant visual. And then there's the ones that you take a picture every so often where you say you do a little 25 by 25 square, you stop, you take a picture, you do another 25 by 25 square. Maybe not quite that big, but that's just the number that came into my head. There's those ones too. And I like them both, I honestly do. And my camera has a time-lapse setting on it. I don't have to like put it into an editor to speed it up. And it has like 5 different speed settings. And so I've been playing around with those. And I did one, it's a little 40-second one, and I'll actually insert it here. It was when I was working on the haunted, Happy Haunting Diamond Dot one. So, and I'll just speak over it, just my image will disappear and the time lapse will appear. And now that one was a 40-minute session condensed down to 40 seconds, and oh my god, they are just so cool looking. And I think that's the setting I ended up going with for the project that I'm working on. Which, oh my god, that's a 60 by 90. And it is huge, so I kind of struggle a little bit with that because I'm telling you, that time lapse is going to turn out to be close to 3 hours, I'm guessing. And so, yeah, I don't. Hopefully the people that I'm doing it for will like it. There's other ways that you can cut it down. You know, you could do like 5 minutes, do like a little time, like a clock transition, and then the painting will be a little bit further along, and then you could do another 5 minutes. See, there's many ways to do a really good time lapse. I used my own paintings to kind of practice with it, and then whatever I found to be the most successful is what I use next. Okay, so I saw, now I'm trying to find whatever's left over. And I saw this little side-by-side arrow right here. And I've already used that one, so I'm gonna put my tweezers there and grab that one and come back to it in just one second. I just want to make sure I got all of these. Chances are I didn't. And I'm certainly not somebody who can just come back to it at the end. I wish I could. I try. And I just get kind of stressed out. And I almost need to come back and put that in place. So it doesn't appear like there's any more of the double lines. So I'm trying to grab the jar so you can see the one that I'm working on. Oh, and maybe I didn't even do that arrow yet. So this is the one I'm working on. And it's blurry. That's not my camera. That is how I just cut them out. I like made a copy of it and cut it out, and that my ink was about running out at the time. So let me just grab my jar here and take one out. And yeah, I can get kind of annoying doing something like this over and over and over. And I heard one drop. You know, having to stop constantly and put one in that I missed. And so the beauty of this is I can also watch the time, so I don't have to be like, okay guys, I think we have to stop and put a new clip. I'm sure I still will. I don't know who I'm fooling. There it is. So we will start the tag after I switch clips, which will be in about 2 minutes here. I'm trying to think. I thought that there was something else. Oh, I had told you guys that we had some pretty wicked weather here. And I had asked my husband if he would essentially take some footage of the lake because, oh, his workplace. Ah, I knew that was going to happen. I knew it. Good thing there's only a few of them. For some stupid reason, I didn't put the cover on the jar. He works on the lake, and I thought it would be really cool to show you guys the lake. It wasn't as violent as I thought, but it's still really cool to see, like, just the waves coming in. And he tried to get it when it was calm as well, so there'll be a couple images of the lake kind of wild, and then there'll be one of it more calm. And this is for all of you that know Lake Superior well and miss it. I knew there was another one. And maybe haven't got to see it in a while. So I will put that in when I switch clips because it would be the perfect time since there already be a silence for me to edit out. And I'm just going in order. I'm working with this one. Let me shut this focus off. I'm just working out of this particular container. And then I take the lid and I put it in there so it kind of elevates it. I don't know if you can see that. So that's what I'm doing with this one. I love these containers. I was using these as permanent storage for a while. And I hadn't used them for a project, so I really didn't like them for a little while. And then when I switched, took permanent storage out of these and put them into the file or the 3-ring binder system, this is the first project I used this for, and I really, really like it. But all I had left was this and then this stack. So I just used both and put the ones that had a lot in it and the last three. So I just did whatever I had to. So it is that time. I'm going to switch clips, get something to drink, and when we come back, I'll start the tag. There is 50 questions, so we will get through as much as we can. I'm going to try to do 2 more clips, so we'll get as far as we can, and if we're close to being finished with it, then we'll just finish it. So, alright, you'll see a little pause here while I switch clips. Thank you. So, hopefully that was a nice little reminder of the twin ports for anybody that knows and loves Lake Superior. So, now we are going to work on the X's. And I'll get autofocus back on so that it's not going in and out. And you know, the last two I've been working on upside down. I don't know what it is about me saving that for you guys. I'm so sorry. I can imagine that it may get slightly confusing. So before I start the tag, there's one thing I did want to share. Because I got this huacan just before, like, everybody started getting the really crappy canvases and, like, the really garbagey drills. So this is, like, on the cusp of when those issues started happening. And what I've been doing is, since I transferred them out of their bags, I actually hang on to these and I just put any garbage into their own tray in case I run out and in case I don't have backups. I know it seems like a lot of work, but I started doing this almost right away on my first one from the company that shall not be named because they were so terrible and I ran out and I actually ended up having to go back through the garbage, but everything was in one garbage tray so I couldn't easily find them. And at one point I ended up just ordering replacements because there's that many garbage ones that I just wasn't willing to use. I don't use holes even if they're small, unless they can be hidden easily. And, you know, that's not to say that some don't get by, but I don't use them if it's within my power not to do so. And typically, if I see them, if they bother me, depending on the day, the time, my feeling, whatever, I will pluck them out and replace them with a different one. So, I have been known to do that. So, even like these ones that are connected together like this, I used to cut them apart, but if I don't have to, I won't. And those are usually the first ones that I'll go to if I need to. And I mean, this can, depending on the color, it can be really bad. Some of these have such bad holes in them that it's like creepy almost. I don't know why. So, why don't we get started on this tag? Some of these questions I may or may not answer, only because I literally just answered them in my last Drill With Me video. Oops, I knew it was a hole. And there's no sense in answering them again, or I'll just answer them very quickly. Alright, so the first question is, are you named after anybody? Right? Are you named after anyone? And in a weird way, I am. Like, my middle name is Angelique, and that was my mom's grandma or great-grandma, one of the two. She was passed before I met her, but I love that middle name. I think it's really pretty. And I actually, when I made a name for my clothing company that I never really made, it was a name that I had picked in case I ever did make a clothing company. I actually named it Halo Angelique. And I think that there's a Facebook page out there somewhere. And Halo is the nickname that we used to call my daughter. Her name is Haley, and we used to call her Halo. I don't remember why. I think it was just easier for my friend's kids to say Halo. And it was just cute. Why not? And every little girl at that time was named Haley, so we needed something to differentiate her from the pack. I mean, I'm not even kidding. I think in her first grade class, there was like three other Haleys. It was a little insane. All spelled differently, of course. So, question number two. When was the last time you cried? Well, if you know me, then you would know I cry all the time. I cry over everything. So, today was the last time I cried, and I will cry if I'm happy, sad, mad, glad, it doesn't matter. Any emotion that I have, if I feel it too much or too strong, I cry. And the reason I cried today was the first person I ever subscribed to on YouTube was her channel name is Jen Loves Reviews. And when I started watching her, she was primarily doing unboxings and like Pinterest hacks, like testing Pinterest hacks. Well, I was watching her video and she's doing this massive giveaway with 10 different prizes. So if you like makeup and skincare and stuff, you really should go subscribe to her and check out her videos. She doesn't do as many unboxings anymore. She does like BoxyCharm, I think is the only one she does anymore. And anyway, she does mostly makeup reviews now. And she has What's Up in Makeup Minute now. I mean, she's just awesome. Like when I first subscribed to her, she only had a couple thousand. And now she's in the hundreds of thousands. It's really amazing to see. And she's very honest. You know, you want a good, honest reviewer of makeup products and beauty products in general. She's an awesome one to go see. Well, anyway, the reason that she's doing this massive giveaway, and I have no idea where my drill went. Here it is. Is because she just hit 10 million views on YouTube. And that is an amazing accomplishment for any YouTuber. Her videos have been viewed 10 million times. Can you imagine? That's not just 1 million, 10 million. That's a ton. I don't think I could ever achieve something like that. I think I'm around 70,000. So I got quite a ways to go. So I was listening to her talk about it and how happy she was and how, like, thankful she was. And so she got teary-eyed and, of course, then I got teary-eyed and it was a happy tears, which is most often the case for me, but, you know, there are those occasional other kind of tears. So question number 3 is a stupid one. It's how many kids do you have? Oh, do you have kids? If no, how many do you want? Well, obviously I have kids. I just talked about 2 of them, but I have 3 kids. I have Gavin, who's 19, Haley, who's 15, and Talyn, who's 11, almost 12. He'll be 12 in just a couple months here. So they're all in double digits. I would have wanted another. I would have wanted to have 2 boys, 2 girls. I don't know. But I had a hysterectomy a few years back, which is a whole story that I told in a different drill with me. So, I mean, if you really want to know that story, you'll have to go back, and I don't even know which one, so you'll have to watch them all. No, if I can remember which one it is, I will link it up in the cards, but I highly doubt I'm going to remember. I probably have to look at comments to know. I don't think it was way too far back, but I don't also think it was all that recent either. So it's number 4. If you were another person, would you be a friend of yourself? So if I was not me, would I be friends with me? Well, of course. I'm a good friend. I am a trustworthy friend. I'm an honest friend. You know, I wouldn't lie to you. I'm maybe sometimes brutally honest. You know, I am a good listener. I can listen without giving my opinion, but I can also give my opinion when I know it's needed. I'll never tell your secrets. I'm just not like that. I got so many secrets in here. I forget most of this stuff most of the time. Like, I don't have the best memory. So, you can really count on me to keep your secret. Hey, maybe I'll talk to my husband about it, but he is my best friend, so. And he certainly isn't gonna tell anyone, but yes, I would be friends with myself. I'm a cool person. I'm a cool girl. And it's a little egotistical, but what YouTuber isn't just even the slightest bit egotistical? So, 5. Do you use sarcasm a lot? No. Why would I do that? Of course I do. My whole family is sarcastic. I mean, you really got to have a sense of humor to be a part of my family. like, one big thing in my family is, you know you're loved if you're teased. So, I don't know, we're pretty lighthearted and fun, jovial family, and, you know, it makes for some interesting conversations, you know, but we also know when to be serious. I mean, sometimes, you know, we try to use sarcasm to cheer people up. You know, sometimes we just aren't having it. We don't want it. But my husband, I was not always super sarcastic, but my husband is very sarcastic. And so you just kind of got to learn to go with it. And I don't mind. I think it's good to have a little bit of sarcasm and not take everything in life super seriously. So let's see. What's the first thing you notice about people? Question 6. The first thing I notice about people, well, I don't know, because it depends on the situation. I guess typically I notice their face first. Or if they're wearing some really cool shoes, I'll notice that. It just depends on the day, the situation, what I'm doing. If I'm sitting down in a restaurant, then I'm going to notice their face first because they're walking up to talk to me or to take my order or whatnot. Things like that. If I'm at Walmart, I guess I notice what a person's wearing. And that's just because I like clothes. I'm very interested in that kind of stuff. You know, so I don't know. It just really depends. If somebody's coming up to talk to me face to face, I guess I notice their eyes. I'm big on eyes and eye color and facial features in general. I'm always that friend that when you have a baby, I'm like, oh my god, they look just like you, or oh my god, they look just like the dad. I don't know, I like that kind of stuff. It's interesting to me. So yeah, it's pretty situational. But most likely it's what they're wearing or their whole body. Like maybe even body language. I can pick up on that a lot and I'll notice that right away. Stuff like that. Alright. What is your eye color? Well, my eye color is kind of boring. It's blue. And it's like the most common shade of blue. It's not even like a cool shade of blue. It's just like the normal, typical, what you think of when you think of a blue-eyed person. Okay, I think I need to switch to the drill pen because everything is just kind of jumping out. But, you know, I'm just going to switch gears for 1 second. These Evermoment ones are so much nicer than the huacan ones. For one, they're shaped a little bit differently. They're a little bit more heavy-duty. Let me grab the huacan ones. The tips are a little different, too. Reaching, hoping not to spill my water all over. Okay, so I always thought that they were the exact same, but let's take this cover off. See, they're shaped just the teeniest, tiniest bit different, but I mean, they're almost identical. But you see, like, huacan's got the divot and Evermoment's is more round. I do like these ones better. The huacan ones, I just reshaped them, but they tend to get bent. See, it won't focus for you because I usually have to take some pliers or some needle nose pliers and like re-bend them back into shape. These ones just started doing it, but they don't do it as often as the huacan ones. So I just wanted to say that because I've been meaning to point that out. And see if anyone else noticed that too. I do love both of these tweezers though. And I can't wait till my other Evermoment order comes in so I can get another pair of these. I didn't think that there was ever a reason to have more than one. But there is. I have them all over. I use my huacan. I keep one in my working caddy. The Evermoment ones come with this kit. Because I have been working on 2 kits at a time lately. And then I have another set of huacan ones that are with my cross-stitch stuff. And I don't know why I went over there to work. I'm not even done over here. This is why I miss things. Okay, so let's get back into our tag. We're moving pretty quickly, so that's good. Number 8, scary movie or happy endings? Well, that's definitely happy endings. I don't do scary. I used to really like scary movies and stuff, but I just can't handle it anymore. It sticks with me too much, and then I have the most insane, weird, like, dreams and nightmares. I just can't do scary anymore. I think it was when Texas Chainsaw Massacre or something like that came out. God, when I was younger. And I had nightmares for a week. And that was the first time that had ever happened to me after watching a scary movie. I can't do the ghost story. I can't do anything like that. Like, M. Night Shyamalan movies I can watch for some reason. And, like, I can watch American... I just said I was going back to this. I can watch American Horror Story. I guess because the acting is so good and there's only so much they can do on TV. Or so I assumed. You know, this is a cute pen, but this gets in the way more than anything. And we need to go back on autofocus. There we go. So, I'll do my best to stay out of your way, but like I said, most people aren't watching this for technique. If you are, then you need to find a different video. You need to find a technique video. Because this most certainly is not it. Unless you want to know how an OCD person diamond paints. So yeah, I don't do the scary movie stuff anymore. I don't know what it is. If it's a scary movie that I've seen multiple times, then that's different because I know. And even knowing that they're not real doesn't help. It makes it worse, I think. Because it's just crazy what you can do with computer graphics and cinematography and stuff like that. But then, strangely enough, I can watch, like, IDTV all day long. And I think that's scarier than any scary movie out there because it's real life. It is really hard to diamond paint without trying to get in the way. Alright, next question. Oh, favorite smells 9. Ooh, this is a good one. I have so many favorite smells. But the first thing that comes to mind is the smell of lilacs. I've always had lilac bushes somewhat nearby me. And I absolutely love and adore that smell. I'll even buy wax melts if they smell identical to a lilac bush. Princess keeps trying to take the spotlight. What a witch. I hope she heard it. Other favorite smells, it mostly comes in the form of, what are those, like, essential oils? I love essential oils, and there's so many good smells, like lemongrass. I love lemongrass. I love lavender, of course. I like, oh geez, there's just too many to even, oh, rose water. I love rose water. I actually make my own, I haven't done it for quite a while, but I make my own rose water, and then I make different things out of that, and I gave, for my birthday 1 year, I had a makeup party, because I never did anything like that when I was younger, so this was like 2 years ago, and I gave my friends, I bought a bunch of, like, my favorite makeup, put together little gift bags, and gave them all some makeup, and they all got a bottle of my homemade rose water, and I didn't put anything else in it, so that they could kind of use it for more things. So, I mean, you could add glycerin to it and make even more things. You can add so much to it, but on its own. You can use it in the hair. You can use it on your face as a cleanser. There's so much you can do with rose water, and it's just amazing. But it has to be organic, because you figure if you go to Walmart and buy some roses, anything that, like, if they used pesticides on them, you're putting them pesticides right on your face. And I know, like, rose water is in a ton of things right now, too. So, I don't know. So I think it's kind of cool that, you know, I was making it before it became a thing. So, I don't know. Gives me a little sense of pride. And that was a funny way to get off track on that question already. This is how I don't finish a tag. I get that. I fully get that. I ramble. So, let's see. Oh, number 10. Oh my god, we're only at number 10. It took me 20 minutes to get to number 10. Crap. We won't finish this. What is the furthest you've ever been from home? Oh, well, okay, so I live in Wisconsin. And the furthest I ever went, I went to Seattle once. It would have been 10 years ago, maybe 11 years ago, something like that. My husband was working for the phone book, Dex. I don't know how many of you have ever heard of this phone book or get this phone book, or if they even still do this. But he was doing it. He got this job. His uncle worked there, so nepotism at its finest. And he got a job there. But the training was 6 weeks in Seattle. And at the time, we had just had Talyn, so he was an itty-bitty baby. And, of course, it was hard, but 6 weeks for a possibility of a great job that could last a very long time. And we wouldn't have to worry about money or anything like that, because advertising is good money, if you're good at it. And so about the halfway point of being out there, the company gave him a ticket. He could either come home for the weekend or he could fly a family member out there. Well, now this was both of our first time flying, was going out to Seattle, and we actually obviously flew twice, going there and coming home. Well, when he went out there, there was some kind of mix-up with the airlines, and they messed up his tickets, and he wasn't able to get on his flight, which was super important because he had to get there by a certain time. And, of course, he didn't do any of the booking. It was the company, so irregardless, he would have still been held accountable. And so this huge mix-up, I don't remember exactly the details of it now because it was 10 years ago, 11 years ago. And so what it ended up coming down to was they gave him like $400 in vouchers for a plane ride. So he used those to come home for the week, for one weekend, and then for the trip that the company was going to pay for him to either come home or for a family member to come out, I used to go out there. So I got to go out to Seattle, and the thing that really sucked about it was only for one night, I think, two nights, and I had to take the red eye home. So I did not sleep at all. And then my brother was like 2 hours late picking me up from the airport, which is already a 3-hour drive from where we live. So it was a long day, to say the least. Except I didn't sleep. That was my second time on an airplane. Yeah, it wasn't as scary as I thought it would be, but I was still scared. It was actually, the ride out there was really cool because I got to fly by the mountain ranges out there. And I'm drawing a blank as to what they're called right now, so don't kill me. I'm not stupid. I just don't remember. But I got to sit. The person that was sat next to the window, actually, he was from Seattle. So this wasn't a new view for me. And so when we flew by this mountain range, he was like, get your camera out and come look. Because, of course, there wasn't camera phones back then. There was, but they weren't that popular. And so I got out my camera and I got to take some pictures from the airplane of the most gorgeous mountain, like, view of a mountain I've ever seen in my life. And it actually wasn't as scary as I thought. And I actually I'm looking forward to the next time we decide to fly. I think the next time we'll probably be going out to Hawaii. We wanted to elope when we first got engaged in Hawaii, so when we renew our vows, that's where we're going to go. Renew our vows in Hawaii. I think it'll be an amazing trip. So, why don't I switch clips, and when we pick up, we'll start on question 11. All right, here we go. Clip number 3. There might be one more after this. I did promise a long video. I want to see, is this going to be better than this? You know what? You're just going to have to deal with the mermaid. She's prettier. Okay, so we left off on number 10, and we're going to pick up with 11. And question 11 is, do you have any special talents? I guess I don't really think so, but at least nothing that's coming to mind at this immediate moment. I'm sure everybody has a special talent, whether you think so or not, everybody does. Everybody is exceptionally good at something. I mean, I'm good at a lot of things, exceptionally good at, I don't know, special talents. I have a knack for picking up on things really quickly. I'm good at, is it acronyms, initials? I was just telling Talyn this story the other day. So, like, this is the story that's going to come to mind as an example. So, when I was in, like, third grade, I think it was, we had an astronaut come to our class. Our school was in the process of switching from carton milk to, like, pouches of milk. I don't know if you've ever seen those or if you remember those from school. Where basically it was just a clear bag of milk and you would hold it down with your hand like this and then you'd pop the straw in it. And this was the year that our school district was going to start using them. So, of course, they had people come into the class to show us about them. And we were also starting a VIP program in school. And this was a term, you know, not a lot of people had heard. It wasn't, like, super popular at the time. At least not to me. Well, the person who ever could tell the teacher what VIP meant would get to be the first VIP and would get to try out the milk, the pouches of milk, and demonstrate it first. And so, of course, everybody was raising their hands and nobody knew it. And I was like, well, God, duh, it's a very important person. And, of course, I was right. So, I'm pretty good at, initials like that, or acronyms, I think if that's what they're called. I'm pretty good at those and trying to figure out what they stand for. Just, I don't know. It's always been something that I'm oddly good at doing. So I don't know if you'd consider that a special talent. I mean, I guess I don't really, but that's the only thing that comes to mind. And that was the only thing that came to mind when I glanced over these questions and saw that one come up. It's like, well, I'm pretty good at acronyms and initials and stuff like that. Especially, like, texting ones and stuff. Oh, see, now it got loose, and I bet it's gonna fall out. I need to find a good glue. I need super glue. That's what I need. I'll just have to not push on it so much. Donnie, if you're watching, what glue do you use to make sure that your diamond, that your little gold pieces stay in line like they're supposed to? Oh, let's get this autofocus back on so that your little drill tips stay in your drill pens. And I know you're watching, so I don't even know why I said it like that. Where were you born? Well, I just answered this question, so I'll just give you the short of it. I answered it in my last row with me. I was one of the last babies born in Superior, Wisconsin, in the hospital here. Now the hospital system, being as it's connected, they have all the babies be born in Duluth, which is the neighboring town, because we are known as the Twin Ports. And so, if you're in labor, they're just going to transfer you right over to Duluth, so you may as well just go there. But at the time, they were still birthing babies in Superior. It was that year or sometime during, because I was born in February, so I don't know if it was the end of that year or during that year or something like that, but that was the last year that they birthed babies in that hospital, so it's kind of cool. Maybe they just took one look at me and was like, no more, All them babies need to be, we don't want to look at nothing like that again. Oh, jeez. I slay. So number 13 is, what is your zodiac sign? I am an Aquarius. I'm a very proud Aquarius. And then the second part of that question is, do you believe in it? And I do. I absolutely 100% do. I'm a very typical Aquarius. If you were to read, like, one of the more in-depth, like, explanations of a typical Aquarius. I fit that almost to a T. I do, I have a couple books that where I can, you know, do my own birth chart and all that stuff. And I have done it. I know all the houses and all that stuff. I really get into that stuff. And it can be very scarily accurate if you do that one. Not just the one from, like, the newspapers or anything like that. That is gimmicky beyond gimmicky. And I don't even know how that started and why that still continues, because it's just for fun, really. So Talyn handed me a note. Look at... You see? He wrote, "Your special talent is being an amazing mom." He's trying to get me to cry on camera. Thank you, honey. Oh, what a sweet kid. God. Aww. Might have to pause and wipe a few tears. I don't want to cry on my diamond painting and ruin the sticky. It's easy to be an amazing mom when you have really good kids. I got pretty, pretty lucky with my kids. Except my daughter. Just kidding. I'm just kidding. Oh, boy. Oh, the next question. Ooh. Do we have another hour? What are your hobbies? Oh my god. Well, you know, obviously diamond painting. I do cross stitching and crafting and drawing. And I make mandalas. And I do my birth charts. And I do a lot. There's so much. I don't know. I just believe that having a healthy mind is super important. And exercising your brain as much as you can is really important, I guess, because hopefully this question doesn't come up or I'll be pre-answering it. But one of my biggest fears is, like, Alzheimer's or, like, dementia or something like that. And whether it's true or not, I don't know. But I feel like if I exercise my brain by, like, staying busy with hobbies and reading and all that stuff, that maybe it won't happen. It doesn't run in my family. It's not like something that I need to worry about. But it is like my biggest fear. One of my biggest fears. Besides something happening to my children. So it's really crazy. Like, I love brain games and stuff like that. Like Sudoku, that's one of my hobbies. Puzzle game in general. Like, you can buy those books that are like mind game puzzles and stuff. I love those. Crosswords. Not crosswords. That's a lie. I'm not good at that. But I also do like card games and board games. That's a big hobby of mine. I love Canasta. I love pretty much any board game. Me and my friends used to make up our own games, like Double Solitaire. I don't know. Maybe we didn't make that one up. Maybe I'm lying. But we may have made it up. It might exist, but we certainly made up our own version of it, but quite honestly, it turned into a drinking game, so I don't really know if that counts. So, the next question, do you have any pets? I do. I have 3 children. Just kidding. I have a dog, Tyrion. He's a husky, if you haven't seen him on my channel somewhere or in my channel trailer. Or in one of my drill with me's when I take him on a walk. I haven't had an opportunity. We don't have as much daylight as we normally do in the summertime where I've been able to walk him. We lose sunlight typically around 5 o'clock. So if I find the time before 5 o'clock to take him on an evening walk, then I will. And then I'll record it. But I also have to be by myself because I'm not going to record it if, like, my husband or if Talyn comes with or any of the other 2 kids, because I'd rather, quite frankly, talk to them, okay? Not that I don't love you guys. I just love them more. So, do you have any siblings? I do. And that's kind of a long, complicated story. But the easy part of it is I grew up with a brother and a sister. I am the oldest. And I am very typical of the oldest child. Anything you've ever read about the oldest child, that is me. My brother is the middle child, and I have a younger sister as well. Okay, I gotta switch back to the tweezers for this part. All right, I gotta actually flip my paper now for number 17. What do you want to be when you grow up? Oh my god, I have to grow up? Ugh. I want to be a YouTuber. Oh, hey, I'm already there. Goal accomplished. I did everything I wanted to do. The only thing I really haven't done is I don't have my own fashion line, and I haven't written my book, yeah. That sentence right there doesn't make it seem like I'd be a very good writer, no, does it? But I am. I am a very good writer. I have so many ideas, I gotta just get them down on paper. I just gotta do it. Just gotta take that initiative and do it. I don't know why I'm scared to do it. I don't know what I'm afraid of. I know it'll be good. And I know that sounds kind of cocky, but sometimes you gotta be. If you're good at something, you're good at something. And you should embrace it. And you should do something with it. And so, for the most part, I've done everything that I wanted to do. There's just a few things that I want to add to and continue to do. If I never got to do those things, I would still feel fulfilled in life. I don't feel like I'm missing out on anything. I don't feel like I'm losing out on anything. There's just other ways to enhance what I'm already doing. I think I need a few more. I only got a couple more, but maybe. We'll see if we can get through it with the few drills I have left in here. Who was your first best friend? Okay, I answered that in the last one too. Her name was Kristen, and we met in kindergarten, and we lived in the same neighborhood. We played Barbies and Girl Talk and all that fun stuff. We had our own fake names. I think my name was Millie. I don't remember what her fake name was, but we were very much so girly girls. How tall are you? Number 19. I'm 5'5". I'm short. Well, at least compared to the rest of my family, my youngest son is almost tall as me already, and he's only 11. I think he comes up to my forehead now. So, yeah, he'll outgrow me very soon. As soon as he hits that first growth spurt, when he becomes a teenager, he will shoot right past me. But my husband, Adam, his side of the family, they're all tall. Like, Adam is 6'1 or 6'2. And he's the shortest one in his family, so that's crazy. So I fully expect that Talyn will be very tall. I mean, he's already pretty tall. Like I said, he's up to my forehead, so he's got to be probably about 5'2 or 5'3 himself. And I think that was the last one. I'm trying to, like, quickly scan over to make sure I'm not missing any X's. But I'm sure that there will be one or two there anyway. So let's see, what is the least favorite thing about yourself? Well, honestly, right now, it's probably my weight, but that has a lot to do with my medicine, and there's not a whole lot I can do about that right now, so I try not to let it bother me, but, you know, anybody, it's gonna bother you if, you know, it's something that you're insecure about. And I am. I'm very insecure about it. And it's not like I'm, like, super duper overweight or anything like that, but I've always been a super skinny person. And to just, like, all of a sudden start a medication and just balloon up, it can take a really big hit on your self-esteem and on your ego when that happens. And especially when there's nothing you can do about it, you know, like exercise, eating right, all that. None of that really matters. I mean, and then having to take extra medicine on top of that just to make your body function the way it's supposed to. It can be very hard. I found a stray drill. It looks like it's from one of the last colors. So I'll put that away too. So now we're done with that. We're going to move into a color. I don't think there's many of them though, just glancing. So it'll be, I don't know that we'll even put any in the tray. 12. 13. So the one we're going to move on to is R. And this is 777. And it's this like really pretty like pinky color. I like a lot of the colors in here. And this actually has some pretty unique colors to my kit. So I think just glancing, I only see two R's. Yeah, so I'll just do what Donnie likes to call a stab and drill. I do this too. I just didn't have a name for it, so I like her name, stab and drill. I believe that's what it's called. Well, you know, there's another R. I see three. I'm still not dumping them into a tray. All right. Funniest moment throughout school. I don't know, and I don't really want to think about that right now. I don't want to try to put thought into that and go all silent, because I don't think that there was a whole lot of funny moments in school. I was a pretty serious student for the most part, so I didn't really like goof off a whole lot until I got to high school, and then I left high school after 9th grade, so I went to, I didn't like drop out, I just went to a different school, like kind of like an alternative school, but it was where I was able to graduate early. So I was able to like finish and then start, I don't know how to explain it. Yeah, basically I was able to just like get out of there, and I would just kind of do like independent style studies. Like nowadays it would be like the equivalent to online school where you work at your own pace and like things don't have like a dedicated deadline. Okay, so now we're moving on to 15, which is the little hashtag or the pound sign. It's a pound sign if you're about my age. It's a hashtag if you're younger. I guess there's enough of them to put this into a tray. And that's probably about all we'll need. I really do like this clear tray from Diamond Art Club. It's probably one of my favorites, especially if I'm working like something like this, because then I can see through, and especially like on the light pad. So 22 is another easy one. How many countries have you visited? Well, one. So I guess two. The U.S. and Canada. And when I was in sixth grade, the big, I think they still do it to this day, but maybe not in the sixth grade, maybe, I think it's now fifth, but we get to go on a big field trip to Canada, and my particular field trip, we would go to some fort I can't remember the name of, but I remember it being like an amazing experience, and I loved it because history is so my thing. I didn't love history then, so I wish I could have appreciated it a little bit more and gave myself a little bit better memories of this place. But it was really cool because everybody like dressed up old-timey and they like acted like they were in that era. It was so amazing. And then we got to go to a Canadian mall, and I remember us all going to this dollar store and getting super excited because we'd buy something that was supposed to be a dollar, and we'd give them our dollar, and we'd get money back. And we just thought that was the coolest thing. I think it was like 80 cents or something like that. And I remember buying like one of those like masks, those fancy masks, like you'd see like in a masquerade ball or something. I remember buying a few of those. And I don't remember what else I bought. But I remember having $20 and just thinking that was so cool. I got to have $20 to spend in this dollar store, and that I was going to be able to get like 24 things, you know. It's something that I've actually wanted to do again and take my kids to, because they're homeschooled. I think my oldest son was the only one who got to go on this school field trip. I don't think my daughter went. I started homeschooling her from middle school, and I started homeschooling Gavin, my oldest, from high school. And Talyn he started after the fifth grade. So when he would have went to the middle school is when he started. He does online school though. Not, but I mean, it may as well be homeschool. I sit and do his work with him. I'm sorry I'm not drilling as much, but it is, like I said, it's very confetti laden. So I'm spending a lot of time looking more than anything. And if I was in a bigger space, I probably would have had more trays dumped out with just a little bit of each in them. But the area I'm working in, I can't really do that right now. And I've had way too many spills recently that I'm not very trusting of that system, of myself using that system right now. And dang it, look at, there's that double line. I knew it. I knew I'd find another one. And I just put one away. So we just do a little stab and drill and take one out. Well, my drill pen seems to be holding up, but I still think I'm going to have to put another glue on it. Super glue, maybe? I don't know. Let me know what you guys would use. Super glue. Because I think I just need to put it around the edge because it is a little wobbly. It's not bad, but it's a little wobbly. So it doesn't... Oh, see, I almost said there's no more hashtags, but I found one. Let's see how many more questions we can answer because I'm only going to do one more clip because that'll leave us right just shy of 2 hours. And maybe only an hour and a half after editing. Let's see, where did I leave off? 23, what was your favorite and worst subject in high school? Well, okay, well, I'll just answer this in a college because, like I said, I went to an alternative high school where I more or less just took tests and tested out. So I didn't really have subjects that I studied or anything until I went to college. So in college, my favorite, of course, was I went for medical stuff. So I loved the medical classes, obviously, or I wouldn't have taken a course in the medical science stuff. But I loved the writing classes. I am very good at writing. I was a tutor for the college students there. So I'm obviously good at it, and I was able to be quite helpful with that for many students. But I thought that math would have been my least favorite, but quite honestly, it was economics, and that was the only class that I never attended except for test day. And I was willing to take a C because I hated it so much. I would always fall asleep just because it just didn't interest me. And that can be quite embarrassing. It's just, I don't know, it's boring. It was boring. Maybe it was the teacher that made it boring, but I just did not enjoy it. So, okay, we're gonna do number 16, which is 823, I believe. Yes. I wish, I can't find an 820 in any of these, and I really need some 820s. I don't want to buy them because I only need so few of them, but as I've been going through my kits, I haven't come across any 820s. It's driving me crazy because I don't want to buy them. I only need like 50 of them. Yeah, nah, maybe I need 100 of them. So I guess it would be worth it to buy a bag of them for 70 cents and $3 shipping. All right, it's that time to switch clips. And we'll get through as much as we possibly can of the 50 questions. But we have 25 minutes left in the next clip, so we'll see what we can get done. All right, I'm going to switch clips, so hold tight. You won't have to do anything. It'll be like a split second for you, but I'm still going to tell you to hold tight. All right, here we go. Let's do 823. Camera, stop it. And wouldn't it be cool if we were on 23, but we're not. We just did it. All right, what's your favorite? This is a weird question. What is your favorite animal? No, favorite drink? Animal, perfume. That's just like a weird combination of things to ask about being my favorites. So, okay, let me look for holes because I know that this one was really bad while I answer this one. And I don't care how picky I am with 823s because I have a ton of these in backup. I actually am surprised, before I answer the question, of course, that there are not more 820s in my kits. But, you know, I can almost guarantee that now there will be. In any of the new kits, they'll all have 820s. Watch. Just watch. I'm going to call it out, too, if I get one in any of my newer kits that are square. I realize, too, I need to buy more rounds. All right, so my favorite drink, well, it's coffee, hands down. But when I'm not drinking coffee, I like the water that I had showed you in the beginning, the pomegranate cherry water mixer, Crystal Light. Oh, I love that. It's so delicious. It's like that perfect combo of sweet, tart, kind of, you know, essence. My favorite animal is a wolf by far, because that is my spirit animal. And then perfume. Well, I don't wear perfume, mostly because I worked a lot of retail jobs, and we were always taught not to wear perfume, because you didn't want to ever, like, you don't know people's allergies and stuff, and so you didn't want to, especially, like, if you were, like, working on a cash register, which I was always a backup cashier, and you didn't want your customers to get irritated by your smell. And it's actually just a good rule to have in general for office jobs and anything where you're working close to people, is you don't want to be known as that person that stinks to high heaven of perfume. A little light spritzing or a body spray is like one thing, but so I wear like perfumes on occasion when I go out with my husband. And because I used to get Sephora Play for a very long time, which is another makeup subscription bag, you always got perfume samples in there. So I have them all in this little bag, and I just randomly pick one out and put it on. If I don't like the smell, then I just give that perfume sample away immediately or throw it away if nobody wants it. And so any smell's a good smell that's in that bag. Like I said, I'm not really the biggest fan of perfume anyway. I kind of get headaches from it, whereas I never used to. Like, when I was younger, I'd be wearing, like, the Victoria's Secret perfume. Ugh, I can't stand it now. Some of it's good, but I can't stand it because I'm sensitive to it. Not that it doesn't smell good. I just am incredibly sensitive to those smells now. They give me intense headaches. Like, right in my eyes. All right. Let's see, what's the next one? What would you, or have you, name your children? What would you, or have you, name your children? So I guess the question is asking me, what have you name your children? Well, okay. My oldest son is Gavin Dennis. My daughter is Haley Elizabeth. And my youngest son is Talyn James. Their middle names are all after one of their grandparents. And then Talon's name is actually, his middle name is actually, like, multiple reasons. It's a family name. Just about all of the men in Adam's family have the middle name James. And then my dad's name is James. And so I gave him that name. Haley Elizabeth, she is named after my grandma, who was my favorite person in the whole wide world, and still is. She passed when I was 12 years old, and my kids never got to meet her, which is just so sad and so unfortunate. So I named her after my grandma. We actually called her Betty, but her real name was Elizabeth. And then my oldest son, Gavin, his middle name, Dennis. His grandpa on his dad's side passed away a month exactly before, well, I found out I was pregnant with him in March, but I was already like 2 weeks along. So he was born almost exactly, or he was conceived almost exactly a month after his grandfather Dennis passed away. And I really liked his grandpa. He was a really good guy. He was funny. And he was always so kind to me when Gavin's dad, his family was not. So, well, it's not like they're jerks to me either. They weren't the nicest. His mom's side of the family wasn't the nicest. His dad's side of the family was amazing. And they treated me like I was part of the family. And I actually grew up with them. So I actually knew Gavin's dad for many, many years, and we are like high school, we dated in high school, and he's not a good person, so let's not talk about him. He's a bad person. Oh, what sports do you play? Have you played? Well, I answered this in the last one too. I've played just about every sport. I don't play anything now, but when I was younger, I played a lot of sports. I had my own kickball club, and the stupid heater keeps kicking on, irritating me. I used to have my own kickball club. I played a lot of football. I played softball, baseball, basketball, dodgeball. Red Rover, I don't know if you guys ever played that, where you have like 5 or 6 people or more on each side. You need at least 5 or 6, but you can have as many as you want. And then on each, there'll be like 2 sides, and you all hold hands. And then you'll say like, Red Rover, send so-and-so right over. And then the person that you called will run from the other side and try to break through your arms. If they don't break through the arms, then they have to become a part of your team. If they do, then I don't remember if you get to take one of theirs or if nothing happens. But we used to have so much fun just trying to break through people's arms. It was amazing. We were rough. And it would be every kid in the neighborhood. And even in my little kickball club, I was the president, of course. Did you have any doubt that I would be? This is a heavy little pen, damn it. I mean, dang it. Sorry. Of course I was president, and every single kid in the neighborhood joined the kickball club. Because I lived right across the street from a playground, and I have so many great memories from there. I don't live there now. We moved away from there a few years ago. Let's see. Next question. Oh, and I do have a special surprise to anybody who makes it to the end. I have 2 surprises, but one I'm really excited about. Well, I'm excited about them both. Who are you kidding? I'm going to skip this next question because I want to get through a whole bunch. And this one is so extensive that it'll take me a long time to get through it. And it's, what are some of your favorite YouTubers? And there's a lot of them. My subscription list is quite long, so I'm not going to answer that one. I'm my favorite YouTuber. There we go. I am my favorite YouTuber, so there we go. It's just, so 28, we're on 28, and I don't think I'm going to make it to 50. We'll see. We got 15 minutes. Well, really 10, because I have a couple things to show you at the end. So, let's see. Favorite memory from childhood? Wow. I have to pick one. We're going to skip that one too, because I have a lot of good memories from childhood and I don't want to just... I'll have to think about that one. Time is of the essence. Oh, here's a good one. 30, how would you describe your fashion sense? Okay, well, I'm going to answer this in 2 ways. I'm going to tell you what my fashion sense actually is, and then I'm going to tell you what I'd like it to be. So, my fashion sense is actually a lot of very comfortable pants, like sweatpants or anything that's comfortable. I like to wear long camis under a t-shirt and sweatshirts. That's quite literally my style. I live in the Northland. It's not like a very fashion-forward kind of place. So, there's no need to get super fancy. I don't even live in a town that has any clothing stores. So, what I would like my fashion sense to be is a little bit more boho and, like boho glam would be my ideal fashion sense. I love, like, clothes from the 60s, 70s, bohemian feel to it. I love, like, costume jewelry, and I like to be very eccentric. I will wear clothes that a lot of people around here will look at me like I'm insane for wearing. The clothes that I have designed and do work on are all, like, rock star chic in that kind of genre. So, that's kind of the vibe that I would like to dress like if I lived in a place where I could buy clothes like that. I know I can buy off the internet, but it's easier when you can also buy them types of clothes in the area you live in, so it doesn't look insane. It's just not that kind of town. It's a town of jeans and t-shirts and sweatpants and t-shirts and in the summertime, shorts and tank tops and, like, sundresses. Like, even wearing heels to some extent is weird in this town unless you're going to the bar. And I don't go to the bar anymore, so... I still love wearing high heels, though. I love, love, love high heels. I think they're so adorable. I actually have a little bit of a collection of them. Even if some of them I've never even worn. How sad is that? Okay. I actually get to flip to the next set of questions. Alright, so we actually get to go to 31. Ooh, and dropping things. I think we're also done with this particular color. I don't see any more, and this is one that will just jump right out at you so you know you're not missing it. Alright, so we need, not only do we need to put this away, we need to find the bag for the garbage ones that I came across. And sometimes I'll check my tray before I put it away to make sure I'm not putting garbage ones back in. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but every so often, Princess has been making an appearance in the video. She really likes the camera. I told you, she's a camera hog. Get it, hog? Talyn has 3 pig puns. Say that 3 times fast. You're more than welcome to say them, honey, if you want to tell everyone your jokes. Well, I get the next color. I don't know if you guys heard him, but that one was, what do you call a boring pig? What do you call a boring pig?
A boar.
A boar. I know all the jokes, but you guys don't. He made these all up too, you know. He's very smart. What's the next one? What do you call a pig holding a wand? I know. A wandering pig. Right? Yep. What was the other one? It was something about a hog, though. What do you call a greedy pig? A hog. I don't know if that's it, but I think we're close. Okay, so... Yeah, he's not a fan of that joke. And I went to the wrong row. Somehow my numbers got mixed up. Now we're going to move into 17. And this will be the last color that we do so that I can show you my little surprise that I wanted to show you. I've been wanting to show my face on camera, but... And this is going to sound really vain, but I have a broken tooth right now. And it's super obvious when I talk. And I'm... a teeny tiny bit embarrassed of it. And so I don't want to... I actually did film a video with me showing my face. But that's all I could focus on. So I knew that there would be a good majority of people that would also focus on that. And the last thing you want is to, for people to comment on your biggest insecurities. So when I get it fixed, I will show you guys my face. But as an alternative to that, I have a special thing that my husband had made for me, and I'll show it to you. It's got quite a few things on it. Alright, so, let's see, what are the last few? No, just so you know, that was the first time Talyn was ever confident enough to talk on camera. And for those of you that don't like children in videos, then please don't watch mine, because he will always be allowed to be a part of my channel. And I have no room in my space for people. To me, that's cruel. When somebody has their children on camera and you just don't like it, there's no need to comment on it. Just click off. There's nothing that irritates me more than somebody saying, your kid's annoying, or why do you have your kid on camera? I've seen that with people who have their kid in video, or disliking a video because the kids are on there. Like, give me a break. Yeah, it's not for everyone, but you don't need to be rude about it. You wouldn't like somebody commenting on your children or something that you love the most like that in the most hurtful, ridiculous way. Just don't watch. Click off. It's that simple. There's so many channels. YouTube is saturated with channels. So, sorry I get a little worked up about that. But it does, it bothers me when I see comments like that. And it's one of the few things in this world that will make me rage out. Because we are mothers and daughters and brothers and sisters and aunts and uncles. And I live my life for my children. You don't have to live your life for my children. And I'm not even saying that anybody's even going to care. But I'm just pre-warning anybody that might think about being a jerk. Don't. You'll be blocked from my channel. Plain and simple. My son is an amazing kid, so I've always encouraged him to be vocal on my channel. And he knows how YouTube can be, which is why he's never taken the opportunity. So I'm very proud of him for speaking to you guys on camera, because that was a huge step for him to take. So I'm very proud of him. So I would really appreciate it if you showed him some appreciation for that as well. Give him a thumbs up. And his name is Talyn, spelled T-A-L-Y-N. I love his name. It's one of the coolest names ever. As soon as I heard it, I knew that that's what his name had to be. But of course, I had to spell it unique because I don't breed ordinary children. You know, and a lot of times when I speak like that, I'm not being cocky. I'm sarcastic. And my kids are unique, so we're a whole unique family. We are one weird, unique family. In the best possible way, of course. Okay, now that I've went on a little rant about you guys and yelled at you guys for no reason, let's try to get some more of these questions done. Huh? 31, what phone do you have, iOS versus Android? I actually have an Asus phone. It's an Android phone. And when we bought this about a year ago, it was top of the line. I don't know where it sits on the spectrum now, but the camera on it was one of the best in the market, even above an iPhone. And it's not a phone that you can find very easily. We did a ton of research before we bought this phone. And it was between this one and one other one, and we ultimately went with this one because I am like an amateur photographer. I do a lot of like landscape photography and like gardening photography. Someday I'll have to show you guys some of my work, but so it was important for me to have a good camera that I could get nice close-ups of like the flowers and stuff and be able to do some panoramas of like, because Duluth, if you don't know, Duluth is a hill and the city is built on a hill, so you can visit the top of the hill and look down upon both Duluth and Superior, and you can get some super amazing pictures with, like, the lake. The lake, like, is in between us. There's a big bay between us, and then Lake Superior is, like, we both cities kind of border it. So, yeah, you can get some pretty freaking amazing shots. And I don't think I could ever have an iPhone just because I'm so used to the Android operating system. That I think it would, and I've never had an Apple product, period, other than I think I've had like an iPod. I don't think that really counts as far as knowing an Apple operating system. I think I've heard you're either an Apple person or an Android person, and there's very few people who like both or can go between both. So, and I think I would probably fit in that spectrum as well. I think I would have a hard time switching out of an Android operating system for a phone anyway. All right, let's see. Tell us one of your bad habits. Well, obviously I smoke, and that's probably my worst habit, and it's something that I really want to quit. I don't like it anymore. It's disgusting, and it's like one of my last vices besides coffee. So it'd be nice to be done with it. Okay, we're actually now, because I went on that little mini rant, we are at the spot where I'm gonna pause, I'm gonna back up the camera and show you how far we got on here. And then I'm gonna show you my little surprise that I wanted to share with you. So, I didn't quite finish this color, which was the plan. Close, but not quite. So let me, I'm going to pause, I'm going to clean up, I'm going to turn this picture around so you can see what it looks like, and then I'm going to grab my little surprise. And then I think Talyn is going to say goodbye to you guys as well. So why don't we do that? I'm going to actually put this away so that I don't accidentally spill. And I found one with a hole. I don't know why. I shouldn't be excited when I find garbage ones, but I do. I don't know if it's because it's like some kind of strange little treasure that I've just discovered. I can't tell you what it is that I like about finding them. So, okay. When we return, I know most of you don't watch these, you listen to them, but you might want to watch because I'm going to show you something pretty cool. And then we left off on number 33, so in my next drill with me, I will finish that. And then I still have the Storytime YouTube tag, so we will also finish that one, or we'll do that one, because that one only has a few, like 12 questions, I want to say. So it'll be an easy one for us to get a good portion in. It's not really like a tag. It's supposed to just like help you come up with things to talk about when you need the help. So, all right. I'll see you uno momento. All right, guys, here we go. We're going to wrap it up. This is the little surprise. Okay. Well, first let's look. This is how far that we've gotten. I know it's not that much further than the unboxing at the Elena store, but I thought we got pretty far. And let's just get a little close up here of what we got done. So we got a lot of the outside of the perimeter done. Not a whole lot of the color. We got a little bit of the antenna done. I think it's gonna look really cute. I really do. I like the size of it. You really wouldn't need anything bigger. Could you imagine how much more confetti there'd be if this was a bigger size? Oh, that'd be crazy. I do have a spot right down in here that keeps popping up, and I can't figure out what is causing it. Like, if there's a drill or two that's in there that's maybe too big. So that's something I'll have to figure out before. I mean, once I frame it, it's really not going to matter anyway. So I think it's going to look super cute. I think this is only going to take me a few more days once I actually just buckle down and start working on it. But I'm going to cover this plastic piece because I don't want what I want to show you to stick to it. So a lot of people have been curious about what I look like. And if you're not part of my Facebook group or anything, then you might not know. I don't even think I have pictures of myself in there. So last year for Christmas, my husband had this made for me. And I thought it was so adorable, and so I'm just going to kind of bring some close-ups to show you guys. So this is one of our wedding pictures there, obviously me and my husband. This was one of my favorite pictures of Tyrion, because I love like that sepia color. Now this is our favorite wedding picture right here. We have it like this and in a black and white. And of course, there's another one of our wedding pictures. I don't really like this one because the way I'm standing, I didn't fix my dress, so it twists and it kind of makes me look like I have a weird body shape. this is my cat Carmen. She's very old and she's kind of losing it. She's a lot more gray than she is in this picture. All right, and then we're going to scoot down. This is me. It's one of my favorite pictures. I had shaved my head. The only hair I have, this is a mohawk style. And this was just about 2 or 3 years ago. And I don't even think I'm wearing makeup in this. A little tiny bit, it looks like. Just a tiny bit. I'm wearing one of my favorite set of earrings. It's like a twisty one. It's got a string of diamonds coming through. I don't even know where this picture is taken, quite honestly. I think this was at his Christmas party. So there is me and my uncle. I asked him to give me away at my wedding. And my aisle happened to be going downstairs. And my sister's grandmother-in-law made all my flowers for my wedding. And this was one of the only times that my uncle bought a suit, was for my wedding. Okay, so then we're going to come over. And I am big into headbands. And this is one of my favorite headbands. And it's actually a combo of three. And that's one of my most favorite tank tops. And this is at one of the parks up in Duluth. There's like a little Chinese Zen garden either. I think it's right over there. And so here's another one from my wedding of my son when he had long hair. And these are my two nieces in there. They were my flower girls. And here we're going to come down. This is one of my absolute favorite pictures. This is our first dance, obviously. And we're going to scoot over because it gets a little weird. Right here, this is Talyn. And I love this picture. I just love that she just brought out the purple in this one. And we're going to scoot over. Of course, this is another one of my favorite wedding pictures. I did my own makeup. And I remember the photographer was really excited about getting this picture of me getting ready. And it... Alright, and we're almost done. This is the cat that you always hear meowing in the background and fighting, the vocal one. This is Ash. You can't really see it, but this little lump here on his foot, he is a mitten paw, which means his hands literally look like a mitten, kind of like if you're wearing a mitten. So he's got six toes on each foot, and he's very fancy. He likes to sit with his paws tucked underneath. And this is my handsome husband. And of course the puzzle piece goes right through his eye, so you don't really get to see a very good picture of him. But this was at that same Christmas party that this one was taken at. And then there is me and my daughter Haley. And of course I'm wearing another one of those headbands because I love them. And I don't know why we thought this would be such a fun place to take a picture, but we did. And then this is, again, from the wedding. Me and all my kids, and I have got the weirdest looking face right there. And that's my son Gavin before he cut all his hair off and then dyed it black. And of course there's my daughter and my youngest son Talyn, but that's like the most recent family picture I think we have. I also made all my own jewelry for my wedding. Fancy, huh? And then this is my cousin Elizabeth, who is also named after the same grandma and my son again. And she was one of my bridesmaids. So I thought that that would be something to share with you guys so that you could see what I look like and put a face to the hands. And I promise you, as soon as I possibly can, I will get on camera. And I mean, I'm going to be doing crafts, so you're going to need to see my face at some point. You can't always just see my hands. So, and I just thought that the saying on this was adorable. He got this through, what is that online store called where you always get, like, coupons for free stuff? It's like, oh, let me see. I got a, if Princess would like to say goodbye, we're just about at that spot. Shutterfly. I knew I had a bag sitting here, a cute little, this is from Shutterfly, and he actually got this for free. I don't remember why or how, but he got it for free. He just had to pay the shipping. And he spent a lot of time putting this together with some of our favorite pictures. And then I do believe that Talyn is going to come and say goodbye to you. And now you know what he looks like. That's him right there and right there. And that's it. So I just want to thank you guys for sticking with me with this very long drill with me. I think the next few videos will be craft videos. I know that I got an introduction to a new series within a series coming up Sunday, tomorrow, when you're watching this. This is going to be one of the first videos that I'm putting out with very little editing, so I hope it goes well. I hope I don't irritate you too much. I do have quite a few unboxings coming up in the future. I know I said I wasn't going to be able to do that, but I found some really cheap stuff for some really good prices, and I couldn't help myself. I hope you guys liked the Walmart haul I got yesterday, and I hope some of you guys were able to find some at your local Walmarts. And with that, I will let you guys go. Have an awesome day, friends. Have fun diamond painting. Have fun crafting. Have fun doing whatever it is that makes you happy. I love you, friends, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.